Hello, hello, guys. Yeah, gotta stay quiet tonight. It's everyone's sleeping, so just wanna keep it down, that's all. While I enjoy completing this just random airport that I'm building, just for fun. No, this is not part of the Echternach map. This is just actually an experiment before I work on the next episode. I've been a bit busy actually, so that's been put on hold for the time being. Ooh, I don't like that. That's not working the way I had intended. Phew. The complicated part. This is a bit of a problem here. Hey Paul, how are you? Just the one, come on. Hey, Bo Lemon Drop. Yeah, this is a international airport for a city that I'm just doing in my own free time while I'm not doing a series. If you want, I can give you the rundown. So the idea is there's going to be the city center around over here. I've got the main part of the airport here, so main entrance enters over here, main car park, main terminal where the main train station, a monorail linking the two terminals together. I've got four train lines underneath over here with a underground bus line connected, well, will be connected. Hotel, currently working on this massive car park over here. So this is Terminal 1. It's got four main buildings. So this is where all the tourists do come into. It's got a few parked airlines over here. Lots of completely custom built, of course, as you can see. I've got to put some more parking spots in the middle over here. Got some services over here, fire, emergency, helicopters, police. Got a couple of depots over here. Got some petrol facilities over here, which needs a bit more detailing. And then I've got the runways, or the, what do you call it, the taxiways. Split up with this little water feature, so it really makes the terminal quite unique all on its own. And then an entry over here. So around here I've got a clear divide between Terminal 1. On the other side over here we've got Terminal 2, which is slightly smaller, but still it's got seven of these stands with a few more extra parking spots for planes that are inactive for the time being, just as props. And so yeah, that's the two main terminals. On the other side over here, ideally how this is going to work is planes will land, come in over here. They'll turn right around over here, go down the taxiway, then go right again, and then keep going straight, and then do a U-turn around over here, and it'll enter into the taxi area of all the docks or the gates. On the other hand, planes that are leaving, they'll go all the way back through this direction, do a U-turn, go down this taxiway, join up with the taxiway that joins up originally from the runway. Take a right, then a left over here, the first left, then do a U-turn onto this taxiway, and they're going to shoot off on the runway down there. Now, the second run or taxiway that turns left over here, in then right, is into the cargo area where we got all our UPS, FedEx, and DHL services. And in regards to the water, well, I think it looks cool, and I've seen certain airports do a few dividing areas like this, not to this extent though, around the taxiways, so I thought I'd just push it a little bit more to the extreme, and I think it really looks good and breaks things up quite well. So Yeah, that was that. So now just working on this car park round over here. And I've specifically made the taxiways a bit wider in order to facilitate the wideness of the plane so that the engines aren't going over the grass, but they're over concrete, so they don't suck up all the extra leaves and grass bits. Okay, so back to this car park. If there's any questions, of course, you can always ask. More than happy to answer. Whoops. I do not want street lamps on these. Did I even put the right ones? No, I didn't. That's why. Put something else on. It's not what I want. I want this. Like that. Alright. Now let's do... setting a couple of key unique identifiers against each parking section, because it is a relatively large one, so this way people will be able to identify, pretend that these are unique identifying terms of each location. Let's just copy that and that. I can just go across and paste that in. I think that will work. Oh, that's not going to work here now though. Only work for those. Oh, here, it'll work here. Fix this up like so. This as well. This is definitely coming along nicely. Ooh, that looks disgusting. I'm gonna have to see what I can do with this. Do not like this one little bit. And this area as well. Let's just close this all up. With the footpaths, I think that's good enough. Can put something over here, I don't know what yet. This is not going to be grass anymore. This is going to be concrete. Hey, Jack. Yeah, we'll be back. Just to get some game time, play around with a little bit with an airport. Recently, I've been traveling so much, I decided to do some work around airports since I've been, you know, on the airplanes pretty much non-stop. Getting some inspiration here and there. Let's see how this curb will work around here. Like so. And. May need an Excel of these. Another one right here. And see if I can. It's actually a bit extreme, I reckon. I could do with something like this instead. And medium? No, small. I'm going to place some bollards over here. Yeah, some bollards would be really, really nice. Need to make this though a little bit smaller, way smaller. So make that 5. That's still too big. 3 it is. Alright, I like that. Let's place some bollards, see if I can find some bollards. How does this one look? Nothing special. I don't mind the chain ones. These ones probably look a little bit better. Something not very big though. Oh, that one will work nice. So let's get it going on with the straight line. It's not too frequent, is it? What is the frequency of this? 3. You make it 4. That's better. All right. Let's go jump back into the curbs. Gonna need something small. Small, one of these. And let's see if we can do this on a 3 meter basis. I can curve this. Oh yes, I can. I don't know, we can curve these this much. This is awesome. So I can put some more bollards around here. Right, so what am I gonna do here? Taxi stands or something like that. Taxi stands over here. Ooh. Should provide some space. How much space do we actually have here to do something? Single individual roads would be nice. Actually, let's get this upgraded to this. Like so. Let's make this all one way. This can go same like that. All right, that's fine. Now let's grab our little miniature streets, both all one way. Ooh, I did do one thing bad, and that is forgot to add some zoning on this. Some zoning would be good to have, and actually that's the correct one to use as well, so that there's no parking going on. It does make more sense. Okay, now let's get the little miniature streets. Will this be an issue? Shouldn't be an issue. It's too long. I mean, what can I fit here? Pretty much nothing except for one maybe taxi stand. I mean, it's something. Okay, push that all the way through. Like so, I can put another taxi stand over here, if it will fit, that is. Let's push this back to a no zoning for this. That is there any zoning against this now? There better be. So when I grab a taxi, or don't have taxi stands yet. And change that up. So let's jump back into the curbs. This can use medium ones. And what are the measurements of this? It's probably going to be 4. Still more. More. 6. More. 7. Really? 8. Ooh, so there we go. 6.5. Perfect. let's grab the small one. This needs to be moved to 3. And let's join that up here. Let's see what we can do with that single one. Just to clean it up a bit. Now all that needs to be done is simply clean this up. Medium. No. First time I'm building a car park like this, actually. Like, for proper. I mean, I did experiment a little bit before, but not like... I was just trying to quickly utilize these features, not actually really try, though. So... well, that's not gonna work there, so I better grab a medium one. Another medium one, there we go. So it's gonna come along. It will come along eventually. Need small ones over here. Don't think there's anything else that I can fit in here that will cover this in one hit that doesn't overlap too much. There we go. I'll put some more bollards around over here. Definitely need to put some lighting as well. I forgot about the lighting. Okay, so let me just go here. Let's copy one of those, and those. Control C. Let's paste these here. Paste another 3 here. And I can only fit another 2, so 1, 2, control C, and paste them here. Cool, I better actually save this. Now let's go bam, bam, and bam, control C. Paste these here and paste these here. I don't know what kind of trees I should be putting in over here. Over here as well. Now. What do we need to do here? Go back into the curbs. Go to the medium ones. Wonder if we can use some medium. That's gonna be too big. Or is it? Could get away with this. No, he won't, because a different size unless we go for mediums or even large. Think medium will do quite nicely. And back into the medium of this. Medium of that. Close these. Go that, and that. Control C. And paste that in. Like so. So now what I need to do is go bam. Now over here I need to do an outward. That's not gonna work, so medium, one of these. Not sure if this is gonna work, but we'll give it a shot. Medium oval. Oh no, that's not gonna work now. Oh, maybe. Maybe this will. We need two of these though. To line up like so. To make it look like it's flush. There we go. Now a medium, one of these. These curb assets are pretty cool. Never really played around much with them. Alright. Flick this around. Now I need to go down in this direction. Why do I not have enough car spots over here? I should have more. Parking functional. Oh, because of this. Okay, so let's just fix that up. Full zoning. like so. No, no zoning with that. Now let's do 4 zoning here on that. Jump back into functional parking like so, and there we have it. That's actually a bit long. Might need to shorten that one out over here on this side. And now, well, I actually really like this kind of road around here. That's actually a pretty good idea to have. Let's just jump back into defaults. See how that works out. I'm interested to see if vehicles will be utilizing both directions on that. Okay, ooh, we lost a bit here. Next. Let's see what it starts looking like if we start planting some trees, eh? Or some plants. That palm tree is just horrendous. So I'm going to be placing that. Maybe a palm on either side. That's a good idea. Palm here. Palm here. Ooh, we've got duplications going on. Okay, let's reduce this to that. I like the double palms on either edge. Yeah, it's looking good. This is looking good. Place some plants. Let's do this main part first. I think the main part is easy. Okay. Few more over here, like so. Oh, this area is still incomplete. Now, plants. What kind of plants can we push here? We got a low poly. One of these. Not these. Not in this climate. Not in this climate for these. So the only thing really is we've got is the quarter line, which will work. Let's put One on this end, one on this end. Every two spaces, that works. That does work nice. Okay. Let's just grab that. Pretty much, let's just do a duplication job. Just to make it nice and easy. Not overly complicated. Relatively straightforward. I do need some lighting as well in this area. So let's not forget about the lighting. What kind of lights have we got? Avenue. Parking lot lights. Here we go. I think four lights like that works, so what we'll do is grab that light, that, and paste them in. Should be enough lighting for these car spaces. So we got lighting, got bollards here on the outside, it's coming along. Alright, another one here, one here, here. Light in the middle, one over here. Okay. We got a three, so this can definitely be copied across. Bam. Bam, bam, and bam. Next one is here, and there. So back into the lights we go. One here, and one there, and there. Okay, and copy that straight back in here. Copy that straight back in there. Okay. Gonna need some more bollards here. These ones at a rate of 4 meters, please. Like that. Okay, next. Man, these car parks are not easy to do. So let's do curbs. Curb, medium. Need a medium one. Medium oval. I've got to figure out what to do with all the extra space that's around here. There's quite a lot of it surrounding this car park. Okay. Let's get a large oval in, same as this side. So I can't just create it all this grass stuff. It's gonna look a bit silly if we were to do that, I think. to be further out, but that's fine. Actually, no, it's not fine. I don't like that. That needs to be in line, sort of. Check that back into place. Like that. All right, that's better. Go back into the medium of this. Now, next question. So how do I deal with this next part? Need space for bollards. If I were to put some artwork, I'm sure we've got some sort of nice artwork to put in. We can take a bit of space up. Let's place that all like that, that's fine. Let's get one of these roads. This one. That's gonna work somehow, maybe not. Let's get, what do we need? That in there, that's fine. And upgrade that to that and then back to that. So let's just jump back to these bollards. Should be at a distance of 4 meters. Yes, which they are. Oh, that's really good positioning right there. That's wonderful. This one not so much, but that... that will do. Okay. Some more bollards here. Okay. These bollards add a lot of character to this, because otherwise it's a bit flat. Okay. Let's go medium curbs again. Let's remove that. Let's make it up to a medium over here, like so. And let's put a large circular one like that. So we can put a... hopefully, a large palm tree with some of these surrounding it. More of these to do. Hey Zhao, how are you? All right, so That looks like it's working thus far. This whole car park area. How many is that? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. That's 5, so that's not going to work. I need to create 2 separate ones. 2 unique ones, so that's fine. Let's go bam, bam, bam. Eight, two, three, four, six, seven. Must be missing one. Oh no, they're both 7. That's fine. Okay, now let's get these lights, airport lights that we've been using. One there, one here. Now, how much spacing do we need between? What do we have here? There, 4. These are the really long ones. Okay, so gap of 2 and then 1. The gap of 2 and 1. Gap of 2 and 1. There we go. So now let's just go select all these. And copy it over to the next one. So, okay. Another palm tree here. Few of these. So what am I doing here now? Curb. Let's go medium size. Now how do I do it in the previous one? Go out a little bit. It's fine. Now go with the mediums. Extending out and jump back into the large ones. Large oval, large oval. Small, medium, large. Okay, and just push that out to here. That works for me. Now, jump into medium of this again. I really do have to figure out what I'm going to be doing with this. Extra space in the airport. Because it's kind of, you know, just wasted. Right now, here. Put a big pot like that. Go back into the medium size one of these. And go back into the medium size of this as well over here. And push this through. Jump back into the large one. Okay. That will work for me, like so. And jump back into the medium ones. And that's not exactly even. Now I need these triangles. Pretend that I'm covering this entire space for a reason. So I may need a medium one of these or a large one even. That will do the job, and it's only medium as well, like so. That works. And with that I can put another palm tree down this corner. Few of these down here. Okay. Back to the curbs. Let's get these big ones in. They'll cover a lot of space quickly. And I may need those one of those inverted ones as well. There we go. That works. Gonna need to make that larger. Okay. Bam, bam. Just to cover up as if this has been designed to be placed where the leg of the monorail is going underneath like that. That's the purpose of this. And what I'll do is I shall add one or two more palm trees here with a couple of these underneath. Because why not? And next is another one that goes down here. I can put some more bollards around here. And another big palm tree with a few of these underneath. Okay. Alright, so with this pretty much done, nearly. Still a lot of the outside around here. Still got some bollards to do. So let's get on to the curbing that's still left. May need to just see if I can grab this. What's here? I don't know. I'll see that. It's fine. Okay. It's going to be a pretty high traffic area. Be nice to put some artwork around here. Could actually put a couple of seating around here as well. Let's see. That works. So if I, and let's go bam, bam. Copy that, copy that. Small little details. Okay. That all looks fine. What to do here now? Let's get some more bollards up. Or do I have any more areas that need seats? Definitely. That's all done. One more here. Couple more here. Great. Oh, this car park is now coming along. Not much left to do. I'm gonna add some trash cans as well for some recycling. I did forget to add a couple of these as well. Around here. One of these parking markers here and here. And that's, I think, about it. Another one here. This whole area is covered with these parking markers, so that should be fine. So let's finish this off. Let's get the bollards. No, the curbs. Curb. We shall go for the extra large oval. Place that there. Place that there. Okay, let's get the large oval back out here. Get the medium now. Even the small. Do it in the line pattern. Oops, that's not what I wanted to do. Because what we need to do is to decrease the size to 3 meters, I reckon. Okay, let's grab a medium, medium one of these. Small one of these. See how we go. be a bit of a struggle, but we shall see. Place one of these here. Let's grab a medium one of these. Let's grab a really large one for this section. Nearly done with this car park, thank God. It's taking so bloody long. Be easier just to create car parks, just plop them, but then this won't look as good. Although functionality is another thing. I will have to be tested is if, I mean, it looks good, but will it actually function the way it's supposed to? That's another whole thing to consider. Let's go medium. Small. Oh no, we don't need medium. Definitely don't need medium. Now this section, this is going to be a bit tricky, but we should be able to manage. Alright. It's not ideal, but that will do. Just. Let's go grab a medium oval. In addition to this, and just have a medium rectangular piece. And now a medium oval. Just to close that off. Okay. I think that's it. Just the detailing work now. So bollards. This straight line and bollards. I need them to be at I need them to be at 3 meters. To be at 4 meters, sorry. So these bollards are just to protect the car parks, that's all. I like security. No crazy drivers gonna crash into this. Okay, that's the bollards organized. I need a few more here. Okay. Ooh, I'm missing some more here. Curbs and nearly done, nearly done. Lights. Think of how to fill out the other edges later. For now, I'm happy with that. That's some decent progress made with this car park. I can just add a few more trees, that's all, such as these palm trees. Okay, what I'm thinking is I need the Hertz car. Oh, that's pretty big. Hertz car rental over here. Now I'm going to need some fencing here, so secure fence. This one. That's going in the wrong direction, so you need to start from this side. Thinking of adding some Hertz flags if I can find them. I don't know if I do. Have IKEA, got Lufthansa, Shell. I don't, okay. That's fine. So what do we have at the airport to fill in? Ew, very fancy. Hey Anthony. How are you doing tonight?